With more Automation Direct products being Ethernet capable, what do we need to know to get your network up and running? Let's start by describing some of the components of an IP address. So we have this PLC that has the following IP address. We can see that this address is made up of four number groups, separated by decimal points. Each of these groups can be a possible number range of 0 to 255. So, how can you determine what this PLC can talk to? This is done by using the IP address along with the subnet mask. The subnet mask is also made up of four number groups, and each number group matches up to the IP address's number group to define what it can talk to. If the subnet mask number portion is 255, this means that the IP address number portions must match for communication. When the subnet mask's octet is 0, however, the IP address's number portions can be any valid number in the range. Let's see some examples to make this point clear. So, we have PLC A. We can see that the first three octets of the subnet mask are 255, and the last is 0. This means that any device wanting to communicate with this PLC would need to be 192.168.1.something. Now, let's add in PLC B to our switch. Will these two devices be able to talk? Yes. As you see, the first three number groups of the IP addresses match, and the last is different. Now, let's add in PLC C to our switch. Will this PLC be able to talk with our other PLCs? No. We can see that the third group of PLC C's IP address does not match the other PLCs. How could we make all three of these devices talk to one another? Easy. We would just have to redefine the subnet mask of all these devices to be 255.255.0.0. Now, all the devices can talk to one another. When the IP address and the subnet mask combine to allow devices to talk to one another, this is called a subnet. How do we handle talking to devices outside of their subnets? This will be discussed in the next video, called Gateway Address. If you need any help with using an Automation Direct Ethernet-capable device, please contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning technical support team during regular business hours. They will be happy to help. And don't forget the forums. There's lots of folks there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post questions directed at Automation Direct's technical support staff there. They do not monitor the forums on a regular basis.